Ooh, that hit my... That hurt.
Okay, well, don't push your arm in. Well, normally we have the time to spend, at least on the weekends, for finding some good deer and glassing and running some cameras. And we do a lot of glassing and run water tanks. And 2021 did not set up that way. COVID just shot business into overdrive. Everybody wanted a farm. You know, leading up to this summer, I was as poorly prepared as I've ever been to be on some good deer. And I just wants to concentrate on trying to get Riston one in the youth early season with his bow. So what preliminary scouting, what little work I did through marrying myself to the side, and just we concentrated on he and I finding something for a deer for him to hunt.
So you didn't really have a hit list until really?
Dude, I didn't have nothing. I found two farms. The farm he killed his deer on last year, and I had another farm. And I swore I'd blow out there and throw the corn and get the pictures and threw the Banks blind in there on a trailer and two spots. And that was the way it was. I mean, I didn't have a clue where it was a deer at. So then we had to go to work, and that was that. So.
Wow, buddy. Great. Too much. Unbelievable deer.
Yeah, we were working 7 days a week all the way up until hunting season. We achieved the goal of finding a Riston a buck, and thank goodness he got one killed with his bow. It was the greatest hunt ever. And after that, I really didn't have a clue where or what to do after that, and there was really no time for me to keep doing. We jumped right back into work. And this hunt, I went out to the farm not to hunt, but to do work and get ready for some hunting a little later on. And ended up got this deer on camera. And of the week that I was there working, it was the only afternoon that I went to hunt. He was 6.5 years old. We've known him for forever. Went in there and set up a ground blind, a double bull, and brushed it in.
Well, I came out here from Alabama 20 years ago, and the buck age structure, the larger land-based holdings hold for higher age class deer, and there's something in the soil here that just causes these deer to grow to the proportions that they do. I don't know exactly what it is, but we don't have any protein-grown food source in the antler-growing season except alfalfa. And only a few farms have alfalfa, so to go the kind of deer we have here in the mass and the frames, there's got to be some good stuff in the dirt. man, we got him, buddy. We got him. Cool. Man, we've been after that deer for like 2 or 3 years. He's, I think he's 6.5 years old. Just a heck of a really good deer. Man, we're just tickled to death to get him. But you see him come in, I think the wind sucked back on us a little bit and he was turning to leave and ended up getting drawn on him, getting him shot.
Well, there's blood all the way up to here. Of course, I guess it could have just been pumping out, I guess.
Here he is, Jordan. All right, man. Nice. Wow, buddy. Well, we knew he was heavy, but he's got some mass. Jeez. I'm some more kind of happy. Boy, he's a great deer. Super great deer.
When's the last time you took a Kansas deer with a bow?
It's been a little while. I've been doing a black powder thing for the... Me and Ben Richardson killed a big one a few years back, but I hadn't bow hunted here in Kansas in a while, but man, I'm tickled to death over him. Very nice.
What was the key to the hunt today?
Well, we got him on camera yesterday. I've been looking for him for forever. He's a 6.5 year old deer, I've been looking at him, looking for him for forever, and had some pictures of him in August, and then he showed up back here on a track I got, and I just told Pete I was going hunting today, and you happened to be in town. He said, "Well, I can have Jordan come over," and I was like, "Well, heck yeah!" I mean, I didn't really think he would show, but man, he did. It was a really, really fantastic deal. He's a mature deer. That's what matters. I'm tickled to death.